what's up. Now, if you guys weren't at investor schooling last night, let me tell you what you missed. I was talking to people about how to supercharge your real estate investments by turning them into vacation rentals. Now, if you haven't done that in your career, you got a lot to learn. I've got 25 of these puppies in Florida, and they're all cash flowing like crazy. How do you do that? Well, you got to control the properties. Control them, meaning you got to either buy them, which is what I like to do, or rent them, or get them under lease option. You got to figure out some way to be in control of them. The problem with renting them and leasing them, of course, is that the other landlord who owns the building, when he figures out how much rent money you're going to make, he's going to jack you out of there and figure out a way to do it himself. So don't be surprised if that happens. You've been forewarned. Buy the suckers, people. Buy them. So I do it in Florida as opposed to doing it in New Jersey. Because in New Jersey, what do you get? You get 10 weeks of available rental. Let me tell you what you get in Florida. You get the whole year. Now let's break it down how it goes in Florida. You get the first trimester, which is January to April. You can rent any damn thing you got to rent in Florida during the first trimester. You can rent the back seat of your car, your shed, any house you own. I don't care if it's a $5 million beach house or if it's a crappy apartment in the back of a shed. I know a guy who rents a hammock in his backyard for 25 bucks a night. I mean, anything will rent. You could probably rent a doghouse. So between January and April, anything you got, you can rent. It's a gravy train, all right? And the odd thing is, the later you wait to rent it, the better you'll do. That's a little tip from your buddy for life, Phil Falcone. The second trimester gets a little slow in May. We're talking May to August. But guess what happens in June, July, and August? All of the Floridians rent your house. Why? Because they're home for the summer, it's hotter than hell, and all their kids are home. So what do you think they do in the summertime when it's really hot and all the kids are home? They do the same thing we do. They go down the shore, only they don't call it the shore. They call it the beach. But you get the idea. So you can rent to people from Orlando, from Miami, from Tampa, from all the cities and the different counties in Florida. They want to go somewhere and have some fun, go somewhere different, and they go to the beach. So you can do some great business. So what do you do in the third trimester? All right, well, that's the worst time. September is really slow, so use it to make repairs. That's what I do, all right? Get to work making your properties better and plan all your big projects in September. Now, October's pretty slow, too, but in November and December, lots of people will go to Florida to visit their family members, and you can rent to them during the Thanksgiving season, during the holiday seasons. So there's money to be made there, and it's a true 12-month period. Now, you're probably going to make a major profit in the first trimester, a average profit in the second trimester, and you'll break even in the third. But I'll take that. It helps pay my bills. It pays my bills for 4 months. So what am I complaining about? Nothing. Now, if you enjoyed these tips, you want to get your ass to investor schooling so I can give you a bunch more of them. I've been in this business since 1989. I'm in my 30th year of doing nothing but playing Monopoly for a living. I'm Phil Falcone from Investor Schooling, and I want to see you at my next meeting.